From the moment I wake up is when it all begins. It's all about having the motivation to get stuff done. You know, you can't dwell on the past or dwell on the tough times, because the tough times are what make up the good times, and you wouldn't appreciate it without it. It's not about listening to that little voice in your head, which is only going to hold you back. It's about fighting through that and focusing on the goal. There's no better feeling at the end of the day than the struggle and getting to the end of it and pushing through it, fighting all past whatever people say and whatever holds you back. Because there's no better feeling at the end of the day when you look at yourself in the mirror and you've got those rewards staring back at you. Welcome to the Ross Cut. Basically, this is a great style of training to incorporate into your sessions if you're looking to drop body fat and basically get shredded. I've just finished my bulk, so now it's time to incorporate supersets and pick up the intensity of my sessions.
Ja, willkommen zum Ross Cut. Der Ross ist jetzt am Ende seines Bikes angekommen und wird jetzt in die Diät starten. Wir werden dazu im Supersatzverfahren die Woche 6 Tagen aufgesplittet trainieren.
So the first workout of the week is going to be legs. Basically, I love to smash legs at the beginning simply because it's the biggest muscle group and it's just a personal preference of smashing legs on a Monday. I've always done it and that's just the way it is. Within all the sessions, starting with Monday, the leg day, I'm going to be putting my compounds first, following it up with an isolation on the supersets. My rep range and my set range is going to be around 4 sets. The rep range will be around 12 to 15. Remembering kind of at the beginning of your session, you're looking to work yourself into the sessions. You know, you don't want to go in and obliterate yourself, just basically smash yourself at the beginning, leaving yourself with no energy left, especially with a big muscle group like this. Within the leg session as well, it's mainly quad focused at the beginning and then hamstring focused at the end.
Ja, wir starten am Montag mit dem Leg Day, mit der größten Muskelgruppe. Ross hat die gerne weg am Anfang der Woche. Wir werden mit schweren Grundübungen arbeiten, aber auch mit Isolationsübungen, aufgesplittet vordere Beine und hintere Beine. Die Satzzahl wird 4 Sätze sein, 12 bis 15 Wiederholungen, je nachdem, ob wir eben eine Compound-Übung ausführen oder eine Isolationsübung.
On to Tuesday. Tuesday is basically going to be the best day, which is chest day. Yeah. We're basically going to stick to the same sort of routine throughout the whole week. So we're looking around 4 sets, 3 sets within this session, and the reps are going to be around 12 to 15. Focusing on that compound first, followed by an isolation. We always like to keep that compound lift at the beginning slower, more controlled, and then moving into more of a little bit of a faster paced isolation workout. And always kind of in these workouts, we like to add a little finisher at the end just to really blast the chest or whatever muscle group we're working off.
Ja, entgegen des International Chest Day starten wir nicht am Montag mit der Brust, sondern Ross hat auf Dienstag gelegt die Brust, aber ist auch seine Lieblingsmuskelgruppe. Wir werden auch mit schweren Grundübungen wie Bankdrücken arbeiten. Auch im Wiederholungsbereich 3 bis 4 Sätze wie vorher, auch mit Supersätzen arbeiten und zum Schluss hier nochmal die Brust schön aufpumpen.
Day 3, which is going to be Wednesday, it's all about the abs training. So abs training is key. I always train them usually once or twice a week, but usually when I get down to it, it's just going to be once a week weighted. So weighted as in I like to lift a little bit of weight with my abs to help build some size within them. So on this, we're doing supersets. We're going to be hitting all areas of our abs. So basically, we're going to hit our lower, we're going to hit our upper, and we're going to hit our obliques. And we're going to make sure we're supersetting them all together and keep it high intensity as well, because the aim of the game is to burn fat while building muscle.
Ja, Mittwoch steht Bauch an. Der Ross hat es aufgesplittet in auch schweres Training mit Gewichten, um eben da Masse auf die Bauchmuskeln drauf zu kriegen und auf Bodyweight Exercises, um auch ein bisschen die Tiefmuskulatur zu stärken. Und er sagt auch, aim of the game, also Ziel ist es dabei, einfach auch eine hohe Frequenz zu fahren, eben um die Fettverbrennung weit oben zu halten, und das ist der Schlüssel, um shredded zu werden.
onto Thursday, which is my personal favorite, which is back day. Back day's always been my favorite. Everybody has their favorite muscle groups. Mine just happens to be back day. Keeping within the rep range again and high intensity supersets. This is a session which I've done for a few years now. I mean, on and off, I'm not necessarily saying I'm doing it all the time, but it is a session which I've incorporated in my training for the last few years. So it's a great way to hit target all areas of your back. With back, I always like to hit all areas. So I'm talking about from above, from in front, and your lever motions. Within this session, you're targeting all those areas. The reps and the sets are gonna be incorporated the same as everybody before. We're hitting around 4 to 3 sets on main exercises, compounds first, followed by isolations, and the rep range between around 12 to 15.
Ja, am Donnerstag steht Rücken an. Ross hat sein Rückenprogramm schon für seit ein paar Jahren fix eigentlich und fährt immer die gleichen Übungen. Er sagt, es ist wichtig, oder bei seinem Programm oder seinem Übungsablauf ist es wichtig, dass man den Rücken aus verschiedenen Winkeln trifft, aus allen möglichen Winkeln, und das ist eben alles in seinem Workout untergebracht. Wir werden 3 bis 4 Sätze bei schweren Übungen, Mehrgelenksübungen auch fahren und Isolationsübungen. Wird die Wiederholungszahl wieder ein bisschen höher werden und auch die Intensität ein bisschen hochgeschraubt.
Coming up to the end of the week now, it's Friday, it's the 5th session, so I like to put shoulders on this. Within the shoulder session, it's key to hit all areas of your shoulders. You know, you're incorporating your rear delts, your medial delts, and your front delts. I've always been slightly weak in this area, so this kind of session has helped me put me forward in my shoulders. So what I'm doing is, same again, I'm having my compounds followed by my isolations. I'm keeping my compounds fairly more strict and my isolations a little bit faster paced, but always using mind to muscle. A lot of the time we lose our connection, our mind to muscle connection. So it's key within every muscle group to kind of focus on this. Lots of people underestimate the importance of this, so I definitely recommend doing it. The sets and the rep range, we're keeping it all the same. Everything organized within that structure of around 3 to 4 sets and our rep range around 12 to 15.
Ja, am Freitag steht Schulter an. Ross sagt, dass Schulter sein Schwachpunkt ist oder immer sein Schwachpunkt war. Wir werden auch wie die vorherigen Workouts in der Woche auch im Supersatzsystem arbeiten. Auch die schweren Übungen wieder geringere Wiederholungszahlen und eben die Frequenz erhöhen bei den Isolationsübungen, schneller arbeiten. Aber trotzdem sagt er, dass es sehr wichtig ist, immer, dass die Leute vergessen, die Mind-Muscle-Connection herzustellen und auch aufrecht zu erhalten.
So it's the end of the week, it's the last session, it's Saturday. So no better session than to whack arms on a Saturday. Lots of the times I do incorporate chest and triceps together and back and biceps, but a lot of the time, by the time you come to your triceps or your biceps, after training a bigger muscle group before, you're gonna be weakened, you're never gonna get the full potential out of them. I'm not saying it's not good to do it that way, it is good to do that as well, but it's also good to sometimes have your arm sessions on their own. So within this week, I'm doing my arms on my own, I'm supersetting them, high intensity, the same structure as before, around 4 to 3 sets, and the reps around 12 to 15. At the end of this session, you should have an absolutely killer pump. Your rest times should be quick, but not too fast. You know, you want to have enough time to let your training partner or around 90 seconds go past before you get stuck back in. But really, you should be sweating, you should have a good pump, and that's what it's all about.
Ja, am letzten Tag, am Samstag, steht nochmal Arme an. Ross trainiert zuerst gerne den Trizeps und dann den Bizeps, weil es eben eine größere Muskelgruppe ist. Früher hatte er auch mal im Rückenworkout den Trizeps noch drin, aber er hat gesagt, eben nach dem Rücken, weil es so ein großer Muskel ist, kann man sich nicht mehr ganz fokussieren drauf, den Trizeps wirklich zu treffen, und hat ihn dadurch ein bisschen vernachlässigt. Deswegen hat er jetzt einen speziellen Armtag eingebaut, in dem er Trizeps und Bizeps zusammen trainiert. Auch wie die vorherigen Workouts in der Woche eine hohe Frequenz fahren und maximal 90 Sekunden Pause. Wenn ihr mit einem Trainingspartner trainiert, direkt im Wechsel trainieren. Und am Ende sollten eure Arme gut aufgepumpt sein.
When I cut, I always incorporate cardio within my sessions. I do 3 times a week HIIT training. This is my personal preference. This is what I like to do. Everybody has their own personal preference, whether it be lifts, whether it be battle ropes or whatever. What I like to do is I hop on the bike. I do HIIT training 3 times a week. 30 minutes, 5 minutes warm up, 5 minutes cool down. When it comes to go time, it's go time. So that 5 minute warm up up, it is time to work. So what I do is 30 seconds as hard as I can, followed by a minute moving recovery. So this recovery time is just about keeping moving and literally getting your breath back. If you're checking the time, waiting to go again for your 30 seconds, then you didn't go hard enough. That 30 seconds, you need to go so hard that that minute feels like 10 seconds. That is how hard you should be going. And what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be doing this Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. This is when it best fits me. Preferably on a Wednesday because this is going to be abs day, so I've got a bit more time to do it. But really, at the end of the day, this is what best suits my schedule. If you want it that bad, you've got to make it fit within your schedule. You've got to make sacrifices to get this done. Everybody can fit it in their week. It's just about how you incorporate it into your week. I can't stress enough the importance of going as hard as you can. And upping the resistance on the bike during that 30 seconds as well. It's all about stepping it up, going into the gym and doing more than you did yesterday. Don't expect different results with the same effort. You know, if you put in the same effort, you're gonna get the same results. Put in more effort, you're gonna get more results. It's as simple as that.